is out now.
Okay, and as Megan knows, when you get your first big hit, you can be rocketed to fame overnight, which can be difficult to get your head around.
Yeah, something five lads from Perth also discovered when they smashed the charts back in 18... No, not 18.
Not that old.
That would be, that would be mega old.
How old are these geezers?
1983.
They still sing?
We went from rehearsing in the Perth Drama Club to playing in front of thousands of people all over Great Britain.
Because you've been on TV, people think you're a millionaire.
We do get royalties. It's not a huge amount, but it keeps things ticking along and paid for the extension in the house.
I make a few pennies. It's enough to pay a bill or two, but I still have to work.
We weren't comfortable in the spotlight. In fact, we found it really quite alarming.
This group of unassuming friends from Perth shot to fame more than 36 years ago with their surprise hit, Feels Like Heaven.
It's a song that many of you will recognise and sing along to, but can you remember the name of the band?
It's Fiction Factory, and I'm with the founding members back at their old rehearsal space in Perth Drama Club.
We really wanted to write songs for other people, a bit like the Perth Motown, perhaps.
Feels Like Heaven emerged from one of their very first writing sessions.
We had a whole C90 cassette of rubbish.
Of rambling.
Rubbish. And end of the day, I listened to it. And there's one little section I liked. It was a little melody which went do-do-do-do.
And although the song sounds like a love song, it's about a relationship where it has been really great, but through time it has turned sour, and when that person goes, it feels like heaven. So it is a bit heavy.
We did a demo of it and I started taking it round record companies. The reaction was universally positive.
But the record companies all wanted to hear Fiction Factory play live. They needed a drummer and a bass player quickly, and they struck lucky. Graham and Mike, both from Perth, agreed to audition.
Oh, my God.
Mike now lives in America, but has flown over to join his former bandmates back in their old rehearsal space for the first time in 36 years.
I hardly recognise the place.
I was really happy to, you know, be able to play with a group of musicians that had some good material.
Once the new band had shown they could play live, they signed a record deal and were thrown right in at the deep end, finding it terrifying.
The first really big gig that we did, I was so anxious. It wasn't until the start of the second song that I realised I hadn't turned the amp on. So I had the entire first song without any guitar at all, which was probably just as well.
You're standing on stage and they're shouting your name. You're like, how do I know you?
We've got the phone call saying, you need to get on a plane now because you're going on Top of the Pops. Oh my God, yeah. This is the thing that will say to my mum and dad, look, you've made it.
That was really scary, I think, really. Hadn't written a wee, nice wee tune, and then suddenly it's on TV.
But their subsequent records failed to chart. The band folded, and they returned to the real world.
I kind of regret that we weren't able to sustain it, but everything was going to be judged against Feels Like Heaven.
Every now and then I'll go into a department store. When I walk in, it goes, ding, 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 ding. Oh, I'm here, yes, me.
I'm very proud. It's like the song that never dies.
It's a pop milestone and a pop millstone, I suppose. Yes, we're one-hit wonders, but what a hit.
With the band back together in Perth, they're giving an exclusive one-show performance of that hit record in front of their friends and family.
Feels like heaven.
It makes me feel really special. I'm really proud of it.
See how we plan for saddened eyes. Tears to pave the way. I fought the fever as I knew.
It's so good to see him on stage and doing something that he loves. It's amazing.
Feels like heaven.